I suggest you considering a reading assignment for formative assessment in grade 9 in the unit Earth and Our Place, in it to check multiple choice question suitability. Please read the text about plastic pollution. There are six multiple choice questions to this text. Let's check multiple choice questions constructed by my colleagues, English language teachers, Janat Hetrik, Dinara Kuzarhanova, and Olga Pogorelova. The checklist is provided by the language experts of CETA, the Netherlands. Please look at the first three questions. Are the alternatives put in a logical or alphabetical order? Yes, we see here, yes. Does the stem contain a clear question or assignment? Yes, it does. Does the stem contain sufficient and relevant information to answer the question? Yes, it does. The information is given in the text. Is the question formulated briefly and clearly? Yes. Is the question grammatically correct? Yes. Does the question use the introduction, stem, or description of a situation? The question 2, for example, suits the description of a situation. Does it become visible if the question contains important information that the candidate should miss? So, in question 3, you can see that the word dinosaur is given in the quotation marks. It is visible for students that this word can be found in paragraph 3. Is there only one correct answer? Yes. Are the distractors plausible? Yes. Are words like always or never avoided? Yes, you cannot find these words always or never in all questions. Do the alternatives exclude each other? Yes. Are the alternatives formulated in more or less of the same length? You see that the alternatives have the same length. Do the alternatives suit the stem in grammar and content? Yes. For example, the question 2 or stem 2. You see that the stem is given in the past simple tense and all the alternatives are also given in the past tense. Are the alternatives sufficiently distinct? Yes. No theoretical material about the choice of the text will be provided in this seminar as its aim is developing test items. However, this point is significant. The success of the test depends also on the text chosen for a reading test. I'd like you to introduce you with the key rules for the choice of text for reading testing by working on the checklist of suitability of the text. Checklist is provided by the language experts of CETA, the Netherlands. Let's take the previous text. The text was chosen from two English websites. The text doesn't come from lesson material. Yes. The illustrations are clear and support the meaning of the text. Yes, you see the bottle. Plastic bottle, and the illustrations are clear and support the meaning of the text. Yes, the text corresponds with the circle of interest of the candidates. We think so, yes. But for comprehension, the text doesn't demand special outer textual knowledge. The theme is related to the one of the countries where the target language is spoken. This example shows that the theme is related to Great Britain. The difficulty of the text corresponds with the level of the candidates. Yes, that the text level is suitable for grade 9 students. The text doesn't specially excite or trigger the candidates. Yes, there are no any exciting moments in the text. The text offers enough elements for possible questions. Yes. The text is not too predictable. Yes. The text doesn't contain too many repetitions, enumerations. Yes, it doesn't. The text does not contain bias. The text is one organic whole. Yes. The theme of the text is still suitable over yes. Yes, you can use the text for many yes. The text is free of vulgarisms or other insulting words. Yes, the text doesn't contain any insulting words. Now let's consider summative assessment in the unit and the reading task for this unit. Let's look at the specification. The learning objective of the unit coincides with the test requirements, where assessment criteria are to find out main arguments in the text, recognize feelings of the author, draw conclusions based on arguments in the text. All these criteria require high-order thinking skills of students. And the level of thinking skills here are mentioned as analysis and application. Please read the text, look at the items, and there are three items to the text. You see that questions 1, 2, and 3 require high-order thinking skills such as analysis, drawing conclusions, recognizing feelings of the author. Questions 4, 5, and 6 also demand from students to draw conclusions based on arguments in the text. Now watch the video fragments from the summative assessment procedure where students perform this summative assessment for reading. These video fragments show students sharing their experience of doing multiple choice reading tasks after completing the test and their feedback after having their results.
Firstly, I read carefully this text, and then I classify this text for minor and main information to look for supporting details. And moreover, I underline the keywords that will help me to understand the main idea of this text and avoid the mistakes on answering the question.
If you don't know the answer to this question, you can postpone it, but never miss, because every question should have has its own answer, and just go to the next question. Then return to question you postpone and correctly think, carefully think on it. If you don't know answer at all, you can just choose any answer to have at least some kind of chance for correctness.
First of all, of doing a multiple choice question, I read clearly the text, and after that I know that for what I will pay attention. And after that, if I don't know the right answer, I can choose one version of the test, and randomly, because it's important to don't miss the empty space.
First of all, I have to read the questions very carefully and paraphrase it in order to know what exactly I have to pay attention to. Then I read the text and do skim and scanning. Likewise, I would like to say that fulfilling this test was rather challenging because it requires brainstorming.
Initially, I looked through the questions, and only after that I start the reading. During the reading, I especially pay attention to the parts of the text where can be located suitable information. If I don't know the answer of the question, I just miss it and ask and answer for the next question.
First of all, I try to read text careful and find out keywords that open main meaning of the text. Then I read the question and search clues from a text. After that, I eliminate the answers that are unsuitable options and finally choose right answer in the rest of them after eliminating.
At the beginning of the test, I try to read text carefully, find important information and use what I know to understand it better, and I use my time beneficially to answer to the questions, and if I don't know the answer, I miss it and continue.
In the first place, I read the text carefully and try to understand it. Then I read the questions and try to find out sentences which have got same meaning as questions. I start doing my task from reading whole text, and then I look through the questions to know what I need to pay attention. I go back to the text and underline words that I consider are keys in each paragraph. I strive not to dwell in every question because time is limited. To begin, I try to read the text carefully, and during the reading, I take the notices and of new words and important information. Some questions were hard, some was easy, and but most of them needed thinking.
I'm not satisfied with my work because I take 3 out of 6. And I can say that the questions were challenging for me. For example, questions like feelings and about arguments were very hard, and but questions about the text, for example, missing words, was very easy for me. I think to avoid the mistakes like I did, you should improve your reading skills and not just cheat, you should read with analyzing. Moreover, you should carefully read the questions to answer them correctly, or you can do a mistake.
The question, how many arguments about trash burning are given in paragraph 4, was relatively difficult to me because it asks to be very careful and look through the text again and again. What about my further improvements? I think that I'm planning to read more.
I didn't know some words, and I think that it was the main cause of my fail. And also, there wasn't an exact answer in the text, so that is why I need to think. It was a little bit harsh and challenging for me.
I take the view that everyone have to think a lot because questions were really hard. We should skin and scan text again and again to understand it better. Questions like author, emotions, feelings, and text structure were difficult for me. To improve my reading skills, I plan to read more and study about text structure try to find author arguments in the text in each lesson of our English language.
In my opinion, this test was kind of complicated for me because first and fifth question is difficult for me because it demands deep thinking and analyzing. And moreover, you cannot find precisely answer of question. And about improvements, I think that I will read more, write in new words and enrich my vocabulary or learning or finding a new methods for doing reading tasks.
I have 3 points out of 6. It was difficult task because questions need high level thinking and the questions are not given in the text. You should think, and it depend on your own opinion, and you should understand the text very good.
So, dear friends, this is the end of our seminar. I will be happy if you find this seminar useful for your job. I wish the greatest success in developing high-order thinking items for reading. Thank you for your attention.